You know, we talked about the deadlift, right, and the hip hinge pattern. And so we talked about posterior chain, ankle mobility, hip mobility. So we're going to teach Zoe some progression of how we start working on loading that backside, how we start working on loading single leg without putting you in a precarious position of actually having to get into the single leg and worry about balance. So Zoe, I'm going to have you come over to the box for me. You're going to put two hands on the box, just like you were doing a hip hinge or deadlift like you just saw earlier. So bring your feet forward, right? So bend slightly at both knees. There you go. I'm going to keep that hip right there. I'm going to keep hip, rib, pelvis right there. Don't change anything. I'm going to load up that shoulder for me on both sides. Now, what I want you to do with the left leg is straighten it and push it back towards that back wall as far as you can. Don't change anything here. Keep the ribs and pelvis underneath you. So lead with that heel. Now, hold that position for me. I'm going to have you take this dumbbell in the right hand, okay? Drop this pelvis down. So drop it this way. Feel that hip now? Mm-hmm. Now, I want you to do a single arm row, just like you normally would. Elbow to rib, that's as far as you need to go. Back down. So do you feel your hip and pelvis right now on the right?
I do.
Feel that glute loaded on the right?
I do.
So she's loaded up on that right, getting ready to do single leg work, single leg hip hinge. She's learning how to feed that foot, ankle, and hip, maintain a good core, maintain a good pelvis. Notice her pelvis, I gave her a cue not to open up that pelvis. So she loads that hip more. So I put the weight down, stay in that same position for me. Don't go anywhere.
So what we got here then is we got the body loaded here. We're trying to get this, we're trying to get the hip to actually start to activate more.
Yeah.
So the purpose is that we can get a single leg
deadlift.
Deadlift, correct. So by doing that though, we actually get everything engaged in the right way in a supportive position for when they're not stable enough to do it in the first place.
Well, one of the things that also helps us is take this leg and push that all the way back again. One of the things that she opened up with and started with is this open hip position. So open the hip this way. So when you do that, you don't quite feel that hip. Now take this hip and drop it down towards the floor. So I want you to rotate. Feel that more? That's a big difference in how you get that hip moving.
So that's the compensation technique for not being able to load through here.
The hip, yeah.
Right. So the compensation is like, I'm going to get there, but I'm going to open it up. And I see this all the time with people.
And even a good mobility exercise for her would be doing what's called like an airplane. Mm-hmm. So basically she's opening up that hip, bring it back down, close down that hip. Mm-hmm. Nothing else changes here. Don't change the angle here. Just open and close that hip. Can you feel that hip and glute? So close it down, close it down, close it down, close it down, close, 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 close. There you go.
Yeah.
So that's how you would start to work on hip mobility from that position as well.
Fantastic. That's a great exercise.